ready yet. Our luck will require this. I'm not ready yet.
Umulis on nyt sapara. Super. Bun, bun, bun. Se reișăm pe asta. Pe sfertea n-a curs, cred. Stai așa, 14%. Cred că e ok așa.
Boom. Okay, it will work every time now, guys. Duriel is always a one shot. it is. GG.
Never seen something.
Boom.
Finer.
One shot, Hoda. Just he spawns and he's dead. Hey everybody, it's Rob here. The new patch has just dropped yesterday, and we have been testing the Ring of Red Furore guaranteed crit, and we actually managed now to get 100% success rate to one-shot Duriel. And you see this little buff down here? I'm in a Duriel group here with four people, and I'm just the only one basically that's gonna hit him. I was asking them to kill the left and the right, and then we just do our rotation on Duriel. So what you want is this little buff here on the bar. And to achieve this, all you need to do is do two hammers. Like right now, I'm gonna spend it. Just do two hammer of the ancients, and then you get this little buff here. So whenever you, before you open Duriel, you just do two hammers. You can use like a spacebar to get resources. So you just do two hammers to have this little icon here, and then that means your next hit is guaranteed to crit with the Red of Furore, and it's also guaranteed to do a 1.3. like 30% more DPS. On top of this, we are playing our Blood Boil, and if we don't overpower for 20 seconds, which we do here in Duriel, we don't overpower until we hit the boss, until we one-shot him in fact, you're also guaranteed to overpower, and that crazy scales, you had crit and overpower at the same time. So we are rocking all the multipliers here. We have 700 crit damage, we have 2.7k overpower damage, we have the golden Kappa emote, as the chat shows you. We have the Banished Lord Talisman, which has another multiplier for crit and overpower, and the Grandfather, which doubles our crits again. So we have like some crazy overpower inception 100% guaranteed chance. But these are our stats here, like pretty offensively. Like I don't have the perfect auras here, but we don't need for the boss, right? We just need poison rest for Duriel. This is for Lilith Duriel, that kind of stuff. It's just the boss killer setup. I also have a planner that I'm gonna put in the description here with the new stuff. My builds for Bob, Hoda. And this one is the one-shot boss. And we also have the Red of Ring Furore in here. Time. It also works without Grandfather, but the one-shots are way more likely with Grandfather. So we dropped the Earth Striker completely. So you don't have to do any weapon switch scenarios, nothing, you just go Earthstriker, like you don't need it. If you have no Grandfather, you can still go Earthstriker, but we don't even need to weapon switch. All we do is just open the stuff here, and we just blast him down, basically. So what you want to do is when he spawns, you definitely want to cast your shouts and stuff, so he doesn't knock you back. I put ground stomp here just in case I need some fury. So he spawns, I cast all my stuff, I go, boom, boom. 660 million in his face, and you can just do this every time. Like it basically can't fail unless you like hit the monster before. Like you basically one, two, this loads your gun, and then in 20 seconds, if you don't hit anything, you are guaranteed to crit and you're guaranteed to overpower. There's nothing that can go wrong. Like it's 100% chance. Like before we had like 90% crit chance, and sometimes we wouldn't crit, sometimes we would crit. So let me walk you through one more run, and the boss goes boom. Then we'll show you the entire boss kill setup real quick. Hopefully everybody's here. Seems like this guy. Okay. So you just go to town, you reset, you double accept, go back. I will have all my gear, yeah, just give me a sec. I want to do one more run, do like two more runs. We also want to do a little kill real quick. Just to show you how crazy this new ring is, man. So on the way, usually, so I already got the buff from the last run. So I don't even need to hit anything, right? Because I just did it from the previous run. So what you can do is like, just don't hit stuff and have your friend kill the rest. But then it's like 100% guaranteed. Like I loaded my gun, like nothing. Nothing can stop it, right? So we can just instantly go, pluck the Duriel key here, you get into position. So you want to be in a position where you can metamorphosis him, so you make him vulnerable with your metamorphosis. So if he spawns now, you do your button presses. I did press it a bit too early, but that's fine. We still have another unstoppable. And then spacebar, boom. 680 million, just like that. And we do the metamorphosis to make it vulnerable together with our prey of the week. And then you can do it here. Like I can do like 1, 2 here for the next run. You don't have to do it. You can also do it at the start of the other run. But it works pretty well like this. You just go town again. And you basically repeat this process, and there's no variance. Like it just works. You one-shot Duriel and hopefully you get an Uber unique. Right now I don't get one, but it's about 2% drop chance. We established that. So this is my current gear. We are rocking Harlequin's Crest. We are rocking... I mean, Harlequin's Crest, Shaco is basically giving you 4 to all skills, which is the best DPS option, because right now we only really care about damage. We're rocking Primal Breastplate of Numbing Wrath. This one is just to get fortified, because we have quite a few fortify damage multiplier that just make us even stronger. Then we have gloves here that give us damage when we stand still. So this is this little icon here, like you see when I move, my attack power goes down, and when I stand still, it goes up. So really good. Obviously, we don't need extra Berserking because we just have Wrath and we one-shot every boss, so we have Berserking already. So you don't need a lucky hit on Berserking. That's just for Nightmare Dungeons. This is the boss-killing setup. Tybalt's Will to get 1.4 damage multiplier. Boots is kind of whatever, you don't need the movement speed when you're one-shotting the boss, but it still helps to get there fast, right? Like when you're running to Duriel. And then we are playing Limitless Rage. Again, we have no more Earthstriker, we removed it. No weapon switching, very easy. No big rotation like you do. Two hammers to get your buff. And then spacebar to get Metamorphosis, to get the target vulnerable, to get our expertise multiplier and the general multiplier. Also to trigger our Decimator, because if you make it vulnerable, it's just going to give you a 1.1 damage multiplier. So we don't get the second part, but the first part, that's enough to one-shot any monster in the game. Currently, anyways. We'll see in the new endgame. Then we're rocking Quake. We're rocking Edgemaster, and you see a lot of overpower damage. We're rocking Grandfather. Again, you can play Earthstriker if you want, but it's not needed. We're rocking Shouts to get Fury. This one helps us with our Fortify. This one helps us with a bunch of things. Makes us guaranteed to have our Relentless proc as well. We have the Banished Lord Talisman, obviously, for the big deeps. And we have the new awesome ring. 100 Fury. You just need to do 2 hammers because our hammer costs 70. So 2 hammers is 140. That's more than enough to trigger the ring within 3 seconds. And then, bam, guaranteed crit, guaranteed overpower. Target is guaranteed dead. So that's amazing. These are the stats that I have currently. About 300 Berserking damage. This could even be higher. Expertise is X, and then obviously we attack with a mace on our Hoda. Skill tree is looking like this, so we just go full DPS. This one, we have Ground Storm. Like, this one, if you don't have Fury, it gives you 40 times the Shaco and the Ring Legion multiplier, so it helps. Like, let's say I just enter the run. We're rocking Ground Storm. It can just give you Fury if you don't want to spend your health pool on. So, what you can do is just press this. Press this, and boom, boom. This is how you can get a stack, right? This is why I use it. Like, you can have your London Strike here if you like, or any other skill. I just like Ground Stomp, it's cool. And let me roll the Ring's Tribute, the rotation once more, so you open the stuff. And, like, you know, you want about this distance to make him vulnerable with your Metamorphosis. So let's see here, the boss will spawn here in a second. And we press our shouts, press all our stuff, and then we boom, 500 million. It always works. You see the buff down here? Now it's gone already, but this little like berserking icon whenever you bash, and then again we can do it 1, 2, and we have the buff for the next run even. I wonder if I can also keep it until Lilith. We could check that as well, but let's go over the rest of the skill tree real quick. Where I go to town and reset. We kill him one more time, then we kill Lilith. In a 4-man group, by the way, so it gets pretty crazy for all this. This is the one-shot boss version of the build. And yeah, you see here. We have Rallying
Cross,
just with extra fury, imposing presence for the overpower. If you have more life, your overpower does more damage, more bonus life. Again, this one was for Scared Fury and stacks. Family Shout, we took out the wound here. You can pick it, but it doesn't matter. The Warcry here will fortify. Unfortunately, on bosses, you usually don't have 6 enemies, so we just take extra fortify, which procs our counter offensive from all DPS. Here, these points you can take out, you can keep them, that matter. Full regeneration. It's kind of nice. We have Pit Fighter and Slaying Strike. Don't really need this. It's just big number on Lilith you can hit for when she has low life. But again, not necessary. Really, like, you have so much damage. And then we have triple damage here, like 1.15 crit multiplier, 1.45 overpower multiplier. Again, both guaranteed. 1.15 vulnerable multiplier, again with metamorphosis. You see all the damage multipliers are coming together. Tempered Fury, another 9 Fury. Wrath of the Berserker King.
I need more time.
And we're not even like using the full potential here. Like, you can if you hit like multiple times before you do the final hit, but it's all not needed. Like, the damage is high enough. Like, you see me hit for 3 billion. Like, you can hit for so much. Like we did on the target dummy. But like, Duriel has like less than 200 million lives. So you don't really need to hit that hard, right? Like, there's not really a reason. Like, you want to be consistent. Like, this is 3 billion, but it's like on low life, it's stunned, you know, with all the injured stuff. It hits for 3 billion, but you don't need this. The boss has 200 million, so 1/10 of this is enough. You just want consistency on Duriel, on Lilith, if you're carrying your friends. I mean, alone, Duriel has 50 million life if you're alone. In the party, he has 200, so that's where you need a bit of damage, but it's complete overkill anyway. You saw, like, all my hits are like 500 million plus. And then this is how the Paragon tree is looking. We have Crusher, we have Fire, we have Dominate here for some crazy overpower. Decimator, again, we profit with Metamorphosis. Right now, we are not even specced to Bonebreaker. You can do it, like, if you don't want to pick your effective modes here. Just for more overpower, but you're already guaranteed to overpower in two different ways. And that is Dominate. And the Blood Boil on your Vampiric powers. So you already have plenty of sources and you only need to do one hit. But if you kill the small ops, picking Bonebreaker every 12 seconds, another overpower is reasonable. We're playing Wrath here, like more crit damage, good stuff. We used to play the weapon swap glyph here, Mortal Draw, but since we're not swapping weapons anymore and we don't need the crit chance buff because we're already guaranteed with our rings, we just pick Wrath, like anything that does damage, basically. And also pick Imbibe in another board, and then we have like all the Fury nodes, all the Berserking nodes, and Blood Rage, of course, for another 1.75 multiplier. Super crazy. Well, let's go here. Can do another round. It's pretty comfortable. See, we still have the buff, so we can do like an easy rotation. And before, we used to drink Cruelty Elixir, but now we can actually drink Resourcefulness. Because, I mean, you don't even need to drink anything, but I like big numbers. Who does not like big numbers, right? So just get yourself some big numbers. Boom, 400, easy. Like, still more than double. This is one low end, like, the weapon has a big range. As we get another chest armor here. Kind of want to check this gear as well. But yeah, that's basically how it goes, guys. 4 out of 4. Every hit for like half a billion or more, 400 million, whatever, like at least double the health that he has. And you can get way more damage, but it's not needed. And this is just consistency. And that is key if you want to do efficient Duriel runs with your friends, with the community, with anybody. And this has been the Holta boss killer, boys. Very much damage, and I really
am trebuit să schimb asta dacă ar fi multe întreabă. Nu le-am pus acolo ca să rămâi fără puncte sau ceva, știi? Oricum l-am pus cooldown, că acum nici să stau din 10 în 10 minute să beau apă. Dar... nici să poți să, adică nici să nu poți să asta să dai, știi, adică totuși. N-am unde mai găsesc eu două din alea. Mai stres. E tot? Nu mai poate să fie două din astea. Nu vreau acum să mă învârt aici ca un obolan, dar nici nu vreau să... Uite aici că am bătut. Tot ce-i? Eu ți-a știu că am luat-o pe aia. Acolo știu că am luat una sub. Nu e bine. Nu e bine că acum mai tare mă... Parcă într-un loc din ăla atât de stâmpit. Deci acolo nu pot să fie în partea aia. L-am luat.
Trebuie amuletul bun.
E vremea. Găzit? Tot cred că ar fi într-un turn. Suzeta, n-am cum să mă duc. Bă, pe aici undeva am The Vibe. Penal, am rămas cu una singură. Du-te și caut-o. Mă duc la ușa aia dacă o găsesc. În partea aia, bine, dacă nu...
Ce-i?
Well, asta e. M-am uitat, am căutat. M-am învârtit. E palmată, bine. Asta e.
Întrebare, damage size has cost reduction.
Asta e, îmi dădea acolo niște din alea, dar...
Așa este 31, ok. Cum era să upgradezi și asta și să-i dau gaură și să-i pun. Bun, hai să ne începem pe el.
Asta e. Puta la cu viperele. Dice che tu prepari per oggi.
Allora, in realtà.
Ia uite. Hai să vedem. Deci. Rare to have something so fine. Loch Ness, let's go.
Se pare dacă rezist. Shit.
Ducem cu coteț în jurul, în mijlocul lacului.
Într-adevăr, mi-ar trebui un inel mai bun.
Și asta o idee. Where do you go? Es que tú preparé por hoy urbí. Salud, boy. No, no, barca, no estoy bien allá. sala asta de mă... Ieși mă din apă. Aha, aici a fost ok cam evitat aia. Da, pentru că sunt pești în... Pentru că sunt pești în apă. Asta a murit, nu? Serios. Cred că asta iese numai dacă mă când înregistrez. Dacă dau stop. Okay. Resources.
I need time to do that.
Yours.
I need more time. I need time to do that. I'm not ready yet.
Ceaba, Risa, vine acum și vă dau vouă, Risa.
Bă, ce?
Perfect. Când am zburat eu? Hai zic, rapido. Doar dau.
I need time to do that.
Pink, red. Mai aveam yellow? Ba da, aveam yellow pe aici. Asta se folosesc asta. Mai crește viața cu puțin yellow. O să pun ceva acasă, da.
I need time to do that.
Da.
I need more time.
Vreau să zic că se combinau alea două. Stella Gold Chicken Egg. Avem?
I'm not ready.
I have some new goodwill cover. I've got something new.
Increase the drop rate of resources, L. Da, dai ata si asta. Am doua.
I need more time.
Rocket launcher. Op, deci asta ar crește cel mai mult. Da. Valoarea. Deci asta. Beril. Nu. Hai că... da. De asta am venit asta. Bravo, m-am și uitat. Da, berilă. Beril mă. Aici să mă întorc să pun ăla.
I need time to do that. I need more time. I'm not ready yet.
Trai cu noroc. Riba, riba. Știi ceva, ia vine aici. Ce-ai zis-o? Dacă l-a făcut asta, fac și tu, cum le iau eu cale. Wow. Dacă asta vă că duc două. Mă recuperez din bolturile astea.
I need more time.
Bun. Oh well. No, no.
I need more time. I lack the required essence.
Hai că n-am mai rămas nici căcat de analiză în tine. Ok, două le văd, unde al treia.
I need time to do that.
Trele păcănele? Să văd.
I need more time.
Ceva a fost la sus. După aia cu bor.
I'm not ready.
știi? Nu e un singur mod. Asta nu stai eu. Asta așa un cod. Vedeți pe ăsta. 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 Bun, ce e ăsta?
I need time to do that.
Stai, mă. Am că de fapt asta în jos și ăla în sus. Nu că e una din asta. Așa. Ăla așa. Vrem și altul separat. Care... Na, fă-i cu pe asta. O să-l văd din altul. I need more time.
I need more time.
No, it's just that. Are you? I need more time. No, protect yours.
I need more time. What is this? I'm not ready yet.
I'm dying.
I lack the requirements ready. I need more time.
Huh?
I'm low on essence. I need more time.
Ăla... Nu știu de ce vrei, că... Asta, da.
Vrei.
Deci... Hello to my shotgun.
I need more time.
Mergem în unde aseamnă să te fac, da. Dar după care am tras.
I need time to do that.
Spot. Nu, dar l-am dat în...
I need time to do that.
Ok, whatever, hai să mă duc să iau treasure doar.
I need more time.
Treasure, cred că ar trebui să fac cura, nu? Okay.
I need time to do that.
Două, nu? Yellow orb. Trebuie bine mai aici. Am o da.
I need more time.
Dar n-am cu ce să o combin.
need time to do that. I need time to do that. I need time to do that. I need time to do that. I'm not ready.
Where's that? La asta merge să pun asta. E bonus. Ok. Accept.
No.
Bun, nu am rezolvat-o.
I need more time.
Vreau pe stânga, tot acolo ajung. Bine, acolo-s de una. O să ajung la barcă, trebuie să mă duc acolo. Vreau și Alexa, etc.
Cred că am altă șansă, 7 minute nu mai fac bine. Aia mă duc să-l iau. Ce bună să fie asta. Doamne. Mi-a lăsat că să le consume automat.
De ce la valorează 9000 sau valorează 6000? Dă 1-1 bonus pentru că aia, dar roșul înseamnă că e cel mai scump. Oka. Mai e ceva. Hello. Large is born in order to prevent the user from loading incorrect ammo. Fii mai bun decât ăla?
I need more time.
Powerful. Extra expression, it's short barrel and low recoil makes it easy to end an optimal choice of sidearm, dar a powerful handgun. Deci asta trebuie să-l, probabil o să iau asta două să le vând, fac niște bănuți, bun, cam asta e, nu? Da.
Ce spre nu? Cred că un subioid de la mare bun.
Aha, acolo m-aș duce, nu.
Nu-i tăiat.
Golden egg.
Un core skill vulnerabil. Cred.
Golden egg. Asta vrea golden egg. E brown. Ha. Asta e goldenul. Bun. Da. În față și în dreapta e unul dintre... Am depășit ăla.
Crit, crit cu bun. Crit, crit, perfect.
Ha? Deci trebuie să găsesc. N-am ce să fac. Din păcate... Na, asta era, măi. Ceva de genul 3-3-3. Deci am văzut 3-3-3 practic.
Non-distant phone.
Ok. Așa, și mai una. Alea 3. Ok. Mai am ceva pe aici? Înainte de a... trei, bam, bam, și ala trei. Hai să dăm. Asta. Părea mai mult ăsta. Ăsta trei.
Cât vulnerabil de mici amore.
Ultima piesă.
E bun.
Asta a fost. Nu. Bam. Trio. Bun, 20.000. 40.000 astea două. Plus 2.500 fiecare asta.
Hey, you're all excited for the season 4 roadmap because this is it. Nope, this is not a joke. This is in fact how the roadmap would look like if we actually show what is included and what is not included. Now, we had a lot of doubters at the beginning of the year saying that they will not be able to do 4 seasons in a year, and I said it would be ridiculous if they didn't do that after they knew how much pressure is on them to do things right this time. They did manage to do season 4, but a very, very slimmed down version. Let's talk a little bit about the different aspects here. We are still getting our season story. It's a new storyline with 4 solo trials. It revolves around the Varangian Knights again. And they said they have done a lot for the PvE group players, a lot for the PvP players recently. And now they wanted to do something for the solo players. I will just not comment on that and rather just move on to the next thing. We are not getting a season trial with mutators. In fact, we are maybe not getting mutators at all. The season trial is getting moved to season 5 and probably won't have mutators. They're leaning heavily against that, and it will be a 10-man trial. This is a major concern to me. First of all, this would have been one of the major content pieces for season 4, and I have said this often enough now, they need to carry the momentum from the expansion as much as possible. This would have been a big piece of content for people that are still playing after the expansion to stick around for, that will now be delayed by another 3 months roughly, maybe, depending on how long the seasons will be from now on. From all we have seen, any kind of raid content needs a mutation version. The hatchery is stupid easy for most players and is just a mindless grind, but you will have some people that find it challenging enough. The Sandworm raid has only been beaten by a fraction of the player base, but many of those players find it too easy. So the best way to solve that and let everyone enjoy the content their way is to have multiple difficulty levels, which is what they would do with mutators here. Them leaning against that without any explanation is a huge question mark to me, especially since this is a 10-man trial, so again, hatchery is just mind-numbing to most players. If it's on that same level, then that's not gonna be much content for anyone who plays the game seriously. There will be no seasonal trinket either, since this is essentially replaced by artifacts now, which I think is fair enough. They're just saying they don't want to add another mechanic on top of that at the moment. They'd rather add more artifacts so we have more things to try around with, and I'm completely fine with that. I like the new addition of mechanics they're doing here. As much as I had take issue with some of these artifacts, as I talked about yesterday in a separate video, I do believe that artifacts are a good replacement for the season trinket. There will also not be another update to the main story quest for now, because they say they are not happy with the last main story quest update and want to put in extra time. I haven't played the last main story quest update, so I really don't know what the reception here is, but I guess what they're seeing is that players are still dropping around the same level, are still leaving the game around the same level, so they want to improve that first. Which is fine with me, the main story quest is my personal focus. The Glacial Tarn is fortunately still coming. This is basically the frost part of Forge. You have new ice mobs in here, Lost and Varangian, and there's a huge boss fight at the end. For example, one thing they mentioned is that the boss can destroy bridges and you can rebuild them during the fight. It looks very interesting, it looks very fun. It definitely looks like a cool element of the game, but especially with the current switching mutation system, I cannot see this keeping people busy for 3 months. Originally, there was a plan to add a new hard rune with the expedition, which they scrapped, saying they want to balance the current ones first, and they don't think adding more and more hard runes is a good idea. I agree with that, I'm fine with that. The hard rune, in my opinion, wouldn't have been a major piece of content by itself anyways. And they are kind of working the other ones into a usable state, so I'm fine with that. The seasonal and the world events from last year are coming back. There's a new Legacy of Thrasus pickaxe with a unique skin, and you can get 2 new statues of Cyclopses for your house. The winter convergence event gets a little bit more. There will be more meteor showers across the world, and we'll need that because there are new armors, new emotes, and a new resource, which is so-called pristine glimmer chunk, which has a 7-day cooldown of the riot and guarantees a 700 gear score item with fixed perks, they said. They didn't specify if you're fixing the perks or that item is. I think it's that item, so I think there's some preset perks, but probably some frost achievement on there or something. It's gonna be decent, I would assume, but maybe not best in slot. But rewards are rewards. What also is relevant to me is how the event is set up, and it seems like it's the same thing as last year, where both events are basically just world bosses that you need to zerg over and over. This is especially unfortunate in context of the winter event, which in my opinion was better in the year before. It was a zerg fest and you actually had to do a little quest line that, in my opinion, was a lot more fun. Crossworld arenas and expeditions are not coming with the start of the season, but according to the dev blog, they are now coming later in the same season. And the reason for that is that they want to tie this with another new system, which is a new group finder. So this will be a one-click group finder with Crossworld expeditions. You can queue as solo, as a group. You have a role queue so that the team will be balanced, and there's some kind of bonus for in-demand roles. So healers, a quote, you get paid extra. So it seems like you get gold for doing this to some degree, and you get some triple bonus for clicking the big random button to fill a group. So I guess it's some option to help people out. They didn't really specify what exactly is going on there, but I'm assuming it's gonna be an okay way to get some gold every day by just helping someone out with dungeons, which I guess is also meant to bring some gold influx into the economy, because the gold supply at the moment is kind of low compared to the gold drain, I think, for many players. So maybe this is kind of offsetting that a little bit. If you go into these pugs, you also get a 15% damage buff and healing buff. So this is only in the random groups.
Mic on.
Pre-made setups.
Mic off.
The old group finder may still exist. Hopefully it does, because I don't want to use random queue for M3s for sure. But those random groups with a bonus cannot be on the leaderboards. I am somewhat skeptical about this feature. I don't know how this is executed, so I'll let myself get surprised here. But then again, I might just run pre-made groups anyways and not worry about it. You have to pay me a lot to risk the headache of a full random group where I cannot see anyone's gear, stats, or anything beforehand. They're also no longer doing the seasonal territory control, even though we never really learned what that was exactly supposed to be. They say that influence races have done a good job engaging players, and they want to get more feedback on that. I have a lot of feedback, and a lot of people have already shared their feedback, but one thing that just needs to happen is the influence gain for factions and for companies needs to come from the towers and maybe from the PvP itself, and not from the stupid faction missions. At this point, it's just people who actually want to PvP versus zergs that just run trains of missions in order to finish as quickly as possible. Last but not least, we also get a new season pass, but in many ways that is not so much content for us, but rather something for them to monetize, so I can only half rate that as a feature. They're also doing one more thing that is not on the list here, which is the inventory UI changes that were kind of teased on an earlier PTR, allowing you to entirely rearrange your inventory. You can just have it in one column, you can move things from left to right, you can change the order and all that. Which is great, especially if you keep some things in inventory at all times, you know, put the consumables up top. I like that. So just a bit of quality of life here, which is good. It'll also allow you to batch salvage items by rarity. So for example, you can scrap all greens or blues at once, or even the legendaries and skip all the constant warnings. So that's going to be quite useful and handy. Outside of the artifacts that I talked about yesterday, there's also winged shoes, which boosts your speed and reduces cooldowns. I could imagine that this might be a kind of a thing that's tied to dodging an attack, kind of similar to a shirking effect, essentially like the old refreshing evasion or something, but maybe with a larger value, because the medium boots are open for that, or the heavy boots, and I would think winged shoes sounds like medium to me. So in total, what have we got? The season story that you play through once and then you're probably done with it, maybe with the repeatable solo trials at best, because they kind of talked about that, but don't really care about much anyways. Then we have the new expedition, which is going to be content for a while at least. We have the seasonal and world events that people are going to do, but it's going to be the same repetitive stuff as before, as far as I can tell. No surprise of the season. We have all the crossworld stuff, but that's to me not really content. That's nice quality of life, but it doesn't really change anything. You're still doing the same thing ultimately, maybe in return for some gold now. And we have the season pass, which is that. Along with that, we're also getting the artifacts as well as some quality of life improvements for the UI. I think my tone here has made it pretty clear that I don't believe this is enough for a season, especially following a big expansion so that you can keep the hype going. I really hope they're keeping something up their sleeve, some kind of, I don't know, fresh start that they're suddenly doing after all or something like that, that will keep players interested, give them something to do until the next major update after this, until we actually get the raid and hopefully with mutators, because in the current state, I'm very worried that we will have a similar situation to last year otherwise. Not as bad, because last year we literally only got the winter event and none of the other stuff here, so I think the player retention will be better than that. But we also didn't get the same spike with the expansion, so the overall outcome might just be the same. I fully understand that sometimes things change during development, especially because the team working on New World is clearly not particularly large. Even though they are under the Amazon umbrella, they seem to be very much their own thing. So, yeah, complications arise, but that doesn't mean that I'm going to be happy with basically half of the content for the season being taken away. For all I care, put the bugged 20-man expeditions back in and take them off the leaderboards and reduce the rewards that you get from them so people have something funny to do in the meantime, I don't know. Just anything to bridge us over to the next major piece of content, especially, once again, as always, for PvP. I'm sure the artifact grind especially will keep me personally busy for a while because I just like collecting them, but I can also acknowledge that that in many ways is recycling old content because you go into the same dungeons again you already cleared just to get this artifact and you have to run them many times. They didn't say anything about a luck safe mechanic for dungeons yet or for anything except open world really, so there are still a lot of question marks in that regard as well. The BTR is coming tomorrow, so hopefully that will come with some good news that we didn't hear here yet. We'll of course update you about that, so consider subscribing and clicking the bell if you want to get notified. Also, the Rapier guide should be in between that. Additionally, if you want to get early trading tips, this is always especially important around PTR times where I post them as quickly as I can with all the changes that we're finding, then consider supporting me on Patreon. Thanks to all of my patrons
for
and thank you for watching. Dukesloth, out.
Guys, Ash here coming at you today in Raid Shadow Legends. Welcome to the video, guys. I'm glad to have you all here. Shilu and me talking a little bit of RSL today. Oh, it's going to be a good video. I get the...
Not while I'm in town. I need more time. I need time to do that. I'm not ready yet. I need more time.
Să le vând la 113.000. Avem 11. Drop rate of resources. Una. Nu mă interesează. Care e diferență? Wow. Deci ăsta are 0.90, power ăsta are 1.50. 20. Direct l-am făcut. Nu știu, alt shotgun îmi dă sau nu îmi dă? Știi ceva? Din câte știu, dacă îl vinzi, îți dă... Dacă tu știi, fă, punisher, fă-l. Nu are rost să... Nu știu și locul meu, dar... Că fac 20.000 pentru asta. M-am dus full in, jur. Serio. Asta nu e. Bine, lasă că ne mai întâlnim. Nu mă dăm de Hello Moto, nu? Aha. Deci merg, dar nu mă... Asta rotunde. Well, it's ogre time.
Jesus Christ!
Ia uite-l. Să știu că l-am salvat. Nu, 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 melee. Wow. Sniper upgradat. What do you mean?
I'm not ready yet. I'm not ready.
Unde e Dogo? Dă-i cu rifle că am...
Nu
am rămas. Da.
I need time to do that.
A rotat, nu l-am văzut. Noroc ai... E harta. Go.
Need more essence.
Drago. Doar că n-am făcut rost de cheia așa, nu mai am inclus. Da, e ceva acolo, dar n-am făcut rost de cheie. Am extra cheie. O machine gun. I guess what's the only thing missing, huh?
There's a slash to it maximum.
Ne jucăm de a potrivi culorile, a? Small key, bără. Uite, bă. Ok. Bără, că după aia... Parcă dacă încep chestia asta, vin ăștia și... Nu mai știu dacă chiar poți să ieși pe aici. Știu că... It is coming.
60%. N-a fost nărfuit, ăsta rău. Domn Parvani și-a rup. Hai că am ceva esență.
Bun, ăsta clar e așa. Acum doar trebuie să găsesc. Cam așa. Sunt tot pregătit.
Ashley, you in there?
Înainte de a mă duce la ea, să vedem ce avem pe aici. Aha. Aha. Deci trebuie să vin.
I need more time.
time. I'm not ready.
No way out. Opa.
I need more time.
Nu mai avem loc. I know, I know. We go.
I'm not ready yet.
It's okay, I've got you.
Da, adevărat că așa aveam încredere să arde acolo. Cu un curdeciment.
I lack the required essence. I'm not ready yet.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not ready.
Nu zi hop până nu... Wow. Deci eu trebuie să trec în tot ăla. Acum... De ce v-am jos? Ce
v-am jos?
Acum asta cum mă intrigă asta. Bă, am fost de Nemesis. Nu da, vreau să... Doar nu e... Nu e în față
vreau.
Să te vreau. În catedrală. Da, nu vine un knock knock. Abrisa.
Nu n-am clipsul.
Mă lasă? Nu mă lasă. Păcat. What? Bă, du-te dracu, tu ce roș ai dat, mă. Serios? Wow. I whip that so bad. No!
I need more time.
Wow. Cred că și ăla asta-i seara, așa-i? Ok... sensor, cam așa e. În camera ei, nu?
I need more time.
Rifle? Wow. No. La mine la roșu.
I'm not ready yet.
Dar blue.
Exact.
Wow.
Mă surprind că ce e mic.
Dau și cu asta. Vreți?
I'm not ready.
Unde? Corect? Din România,
I need
bilet.
More time.
Okay.
I need more time.
a break. Asta e singura chestie care pot să intru cu ea și... Nu e bine. Vai cum am luat tot asta. N-apuc. Wait, what? Aici? La nivelul ăsta, două.
Ai, nu, nu, chestiile astea nu se pot. Mai bine nu joc Disobedience în cazul ăsta.
Trebuia să se întâmple vreo prostie din asta. Vreo prostie nu puteai să... A, da. Ești prea aproape, Ali. Asta nu-i bine. N-ajung pentru că... Puta te... Vai cum de prost am tras. Dacă mai aruncă și asta cu...
Rick, cucat.
Tu ce faci? Ce level ai? Ai mai făcut ceva prin Diablo? The Saints
one's gone missing at a time like this. Mischief.
Medic! It's all over and done. Wait, you're not medic. Take a seat. Drinks on me.
Cum mor pe aici? Acoperiși partea asta. Acoperiși partea asta. Cum sunt? Sunt 100! Mergeam pe partea înaltă. Bun, perfect, am așa asta. Asta vreau. Drop down. Aici pe ore. Astăzi a fost una din zilele în care mi-am dat seama că a trecut timpul.
Come on.
Ce-l vă la Reana? No, 7 jumate.
Nice.
Adică...
Ok.
Nu-și bine pe mine face și ea. Bea din ala rotund. Ia să ne... Am cam făcut și tot orașul ăsta, satul, whatever. Deci în partea asta sunt 3. La fermă. Wow, la fermă sunt 3? Deci nu trebuia să mă întorc pe acolo. Cumva m-am dus bine. Ok. Da. Cred. N-are rost să... ...ca să se obosească. No.
I'm not ready yet.
Păcat. Păcat 2.
I'm not ready yet.
Nu trai eu păcat 2 acum. Aoleu.
I need more time.
Bravo. Powder, come on, to shut them. Yes, a bonus. Yes. Something that we call them a bonus.
I'm not ready for it.
No good.
Merge joca, nu merge. Nu merge să farmesc nici solo că nu-ți dă materiale de alea pe care trebuie. Dar să încerc, ieși să încerc, vede toate.
Uite-l pe Ponyo. Ce faci, mă? Paid. Mă putem să stăm pe aici la ceva? Da, e un Yellow Diamond. Putem să facem asta. Vedem și asta. Așa. Fel. Pipa asta, asta. Mă credeam că nu mai e chiar atât de mult din...
I'm not ready yet.
I'll buy it at a high price.
Una. Nu știu cum să fie. Adevărul e că reload. Mai cam... Nu am simțit atât timp cât... Nu am simțit atât timp cât... N-am jucat atât de mult pe pistol. Cum am jucat mai mult pe pistol? Am de
văzut.
Mai luăm un din ăla.
Bă, n-ar mă mai închis, mi-a mergat așa mult.
I'm not ready yet.
Da. Dar adici o șansă pe partea aia înaltă. Bun. Mă chiar am luat.
Am dat, probabil am dat turbo, e obiectul să... Am visat un pic.
Da, e frumos ce-ai făcut-o.
Da, am schimbat build-ul pe Bone Spear ăla cu oase. Nu să mai încerc și altceva. Iar că trebuie să bă pula. Trebuie să fac o leacă din rune, că nu rezist. Eu n-am disobedience. Bă, da. Uite, e băguit. Nu merge. Dă nici nu stare o oară.
Na, să-mi bag ăla. Na, mă lași? Mulțumesc frumos, mulțumesc frumos, mulțumesc frumos. Wow. Dă-mi una. Mamă, da. Faină partea asta, că te ține în priză. Că și te ține în priză, dar și vin pe ăștia. Folosi tot ce se poate folosi, cred. De healere, tot.
Nu mai stau. Pentru World Boss. Mă dură să... Toate rezistențele pe FU sau de la C. Ah, că am pus celest. Ok, accept și asta. Gata, am picat la somn. Noapte bună, somn ușor.